وأقول في القرآن ما جاءت به آياته فهو الكريم المنزال. وأقول قال الله جل جلاله والمصطفى الهادي ولا أتأول.
الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين سيدنا ونبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. أما بعد، الأفعال وإن باب الأفعال in the شرح of الأجرمية. We're talking about أقسام الأفعال وأحكامها. We're going to talk about the types of verb there are and its rulings. Ibn Ajurramiyyah, he says, Al-af'alu thalathatun. The af'al are three. So there's three types of verbs in the Arabic language. How many? There are three. Al-af'alu thalathatun. Madin wa mudari'un wa amrun. The first one is madin. Madin means what? Fi'l? It means fi'l, which is madi, which is past tense. It's a past tense. It's a past tense. Mudari'un is a present tense verb. What is a mudari'? A mudari' is a present tense verb. We'll speak more about that in details, inshallah ta'ala. And the third one is wa'amrun and amar. And an example of all of them, Ibn Ajurramiyyah, he gives it to you. Daraba wa yadribu wa dhrib. Daraba means hit, past tense. Okay? Wa yadribu, hitting. Wa dhrib, hit, command. So, those are the three tenses and how it looks like. I wrote it on the board for you. The way that it looks. So we said الفعل الماضي المضارع and الأمر. These are the three types. Ponder here inshallah ta'ala with me. So we have الماضي and we have المضارع and we have الأمر. Those are the three types. And I'll speak about this in details inshallah ta'ala now بإذن الله الكريم. But first of all, let's define each of those tenses, what they are. What is a madi? Look at the sharah of Muhammad Muhyiddin Abdul Hamid in his sharah Tuhfat Saniya. He says, وَأَقُولُ يَنْقَسِمُ الْفِعْلُ إِلَىٰ ثَلَاثَةِ أَقْسَامٍ. I say that the verb is categorized into three. الْقِسْمُ الْأَوَّلُ. The first type is الْمَاضِي, the past tense. وَهُوَ, and the madi is ما يدل that which indicates and shows على حصول شيء, the occurrence of something قبل زمن التكلم, before the time of speech, before this person spoke, something that happened. For example, when I said ضرب, the hitting that I'm speaking about happened before my speech. نحو like ضرب ونصر. ضرب means hit. وَنَصَرَ gave victory. فَتَحَ opened. عَلِمَ knew. حَسِبَ thought. كَرُمَ honored. All of them are what? All of them are past tense. And if you look at Muhammad Muhyiddin Abdul Hamid, the examples that he brought, they are the three types of madi that there are. فَعَلَ, فَعِلَ and فَعُلَ. ضَرَبَ, نَصَرَ, فَتَحَ, that's the first type. عَلِيمَ, حَثِبَ, they're both what? The second type. And the third type is كَرُومَ, كَرُومَ. Those are فِعْل مَاضِي. And what the types of forms that they come in, inshallah ta'ala, we'll speak about that in where? صَرْف, inshallah ta'ala. فَعَلَ, فَعِلَ, فَعُلَ. We'll speak about that in what? In صَرْف. So madi is what? وَهُوَ مَا يَدُلُّ عَلَىٰ حُصُولِ شَيْءٍ قَبْلَ زَمَنِ التَّكَلُّمِ. It is what occurs before the time of speech. Before the speech actually happened, or before the speech was said or done, the thing that happened before it is called madi. مُضَارِعُ is what? وَهُوَ الْمُضَارِعُ. والقسم الثاني, the second type, المضارع is the فعل المضارع, وهو and it is ما دل على حصول شيء, the occurrence of something في زمن التكلم, at the time of speech, meaning it's happening when you're talking about it, أو بعده or after it. أو بعده means after it a little bit. ولذلك هذا مضارع, does it show نوع من الاستقبال أما نوع من التنفيذ؟ It does, it's just no, close future. It does. ولذلك there are adawat, there are external letters that if they go before the فعل مضارع, they force it to be what? Past. And it can also make it become what? Future. And even if there's no external adawat that enter it, there is some. When you say, I'm going to put my trousers on, for example, what is it going to be? It may not necessarily be you started it yet. It may still be in the wardrobe, but it's a future slightly. أو بعده نحو like يضرب وينصر ويفتح ويعلم ويحسب ويكرم. All of the ماضيs that he brought them in a مضارع. That is what it means. القسم الثالث, the third type of verbs, is الأمر, the command, وهو it is ما يطلب به حصول شيء. It's the requesting of something to occur بعد زمن التكلم, after the speech, after the talking. The person is requesting for you to do something, for something to occur after the speech, such as نحو اضرب وانصر وافتح واعلم واحسب واكرم. Those are the examples he gave. Then Muhammad Muhyiddin Abdul Hamid says, وقد ذكرنا لك في أول الكتاب هذا التقسيم وذكرنا لك معه علامات كل قسم من هذه الأقسام الثلاثة. He said, all of these types we've already told you about it in the beginning of the book. صح, we spoke about it. When we said الكلام هو اللفظ المركب المفيد بالوضع وأقسامه ثلاثة اسم وحرف جاء لمعنى. صح, اسم وفعل وحرف جاء لمعنى. When the author said that, he spoke about it there. That's what he said, I gave you all the signs pertaining to that. And he spoke about it in details. أحكام الفعل now. Now we're going to go into the أحكام of the فعل. What is the أحكام of the فعل? قال فالماضي مفتوح الآخر أبدا. The ماضي is always مفتوح. What is the ماضي? So look at the board. The ماضي is مفتوح الآخر أبدا. In other words, does it say مفتوح الآخر أبدا? It means that the ماضي is always مبني على الفتح. البناء على الفتح. Remember when we were speaking about that which we do إعراب of, we said the أسماء are three types, مظهر, مضمر, مبهم. Which ones are the ones we do إعراب of? Only the مظهر. We don't do إعراب of مضمر, and we don't do إعراب of مبهم. What about the أفعال, when we were speaking about the verbs, what did we say? The only verb that we do إعراب of is which one? فعل مضارع. If there's نون التوكيد and نون النسوة, we're not connected to it. So the فعل ماضي and the فعل أمر, we said they are always what? مبني. There you go. Now you're seeing it. Okay, brothers. Question now. Question. If we see a فعل مضارع, what's the أصل of a فعل مضارع? No, what's the أصل of a فعل مضارع? بناء or إعراب? إعراب. If you see a فعل مضارع that's مبني, does the person have the right to ask you why? Because it's not upon thee? Good. What about if you see, now we understood the فعل مضارع is what? The أصل of the فعل مضارع is what? إعراب, right? And the بناء is not the أصل, right? So the person has the right to ask you, لما بنيا? He can say to you, why is it مبني? Pay attention here now. What's the أصل of بناء? Is it فتح, سكون, كسرة, ضم, which is أصل? Huh? فتح is the أصل. Huh? مبني, what's the أصل? What's the أصل of بناء? Which علامة is the أصل for the بناء? سكون is the أصل. The sukun is the asal of the bina. If anything is mabniun ala al-fath and mabniun ala al-dam or mabniun ala kas, a discussion can open. Like in the asal is mabniun ala sukun. We'll speak more about this, whether this qawl is rajih or marjuh, and the discussion that pertaining that comes in the mutamimatul ajrumi, inshaAllah ta'ala. But the madhi is mabniun ala al-fath. For example, look at it. Ba, ra, ba. The ba has a fatha on it. So you see, it's mabni ala al-fath. Nasara. What's on top of the ra? Fatha. On top of it is a fatha. And the list goes on. Good. So it's al-bina ala al-fath. Are we all together? So the madhi is always what? The madhi is maftuhu al-akhiri abada. Wal-amru majzoomun abada. And the amar is always what? Is majzoom. Look at it. Al-bina'u ala ma yajzumu bihi mudari'u. Alaykum as-salam. What is it that we used to do jazm of the mudari'? The mudari' is majzoom with what? Sukun and what? Hadf. And the harf was what? Hadfu al-noon or hadfu? Hadfu harfu illa. The same. Whatever you used to do to the mudari' in i'rab is what you do to the fi'l amr in bina. ولذلك, this is why some of the grammarians, the ulama, the nuhat, some of them they actually said, some of the grammarians, what did they say? They said that the fi'l amr is actually is part of the mudari'. Because of this. We'll have that discussion another time and another place. So al-madi, we did it. Al-bina' ala al-fath. Now we're going to go into the one that's big, which is wal-mudari'u. والمضارع مضارع ما كان في أول إحدى الزوائد الأربع. What is a مضارع? What is a مضارع? مضارع is the ماضي that you had, you add a زوائد. Why do they call it a زوائد? What does a زوائد mean? زوائد is زائدة. It's when something is an additional. صح? زوائد actually means additional, extra. Does that make sense? So you had the word ضربة, for example. What do you have? The reason why he's saying is zawaid is because the fi'il madi is the default position. Anything that's added onto it is zaida. Sah? لذلك, when you look at the ishtiqaq and the asl of the word, this is what you do. So for example, look what you write. You write the word daraba. Daraba. What do you write? You write daraba. Oh, am I making sense? Daraba. What happens? You add zawaidul arba'a. One of the additional letters in front of it. What are the additional letters that you add in front of it? Alif, Noon, Ya, and Ta. What do you say together? Anaytu. Huh? Anaytu. Alif, Noon, Ya, and Ta. Adribu, Yadribu, Tadribu, Nadribu. Sah? Does that make sense? Oh, you just add a Noon, Alif. Those four are called what? What are those four called? Those four are called Zawa'idul Arba'ah. They're called what? Al-Zawa'idul Arba'ah. The four additionals. That's what the mudari' is now. If somebody asks you, how do you know that a mudari', you say that. وَالْمُضَارِعُ مَا كَانَ فِي أَوَّلِهِ إِحْدَى الزَّوَائِدِ الْأَرْبَعِ الَّتِي يَجْمَعُهَا قَوْلُكَ أَنَيْتُ. An acronym for it is a what? أَنَيْتُ. وَهُوَ مَرْفُوعٌ أَبَدًا. And it is also what? It's marfu' always. The fi'l mudari', what's the asal, what's the default position of the fi'l mudari'? Al-raf'u. That's why, what do we say if it's mansub? When we say fi'l mudari', are we together? The asal is a fi'l mudari', yadribu. Adribu, nadribu, tadribu. That's what you say. That's the default position. ولذلك, what do you say? مرفوع وعلامة رفعه الضمة ظاهرة الآخر لتجرده من الناصب والجازم. You see, the ناصب and the جازم are additional. They take it from its أصل. When they're not there, the default position, the أصل is that it's مرفوع. حتى يدخل عليه ناصب أو جازم. He said it to you there. Unless أدوات الجزم and أدوات النصب enter it. And what are other أدوات الجزم? And what are other أدوات النصب? And al-jazmi, we're going to speak about that inshallah soon. We're going to speak about it. We're going to speak about it soon. Let's now go into the kalam of Muhammad Muhyiddin Abdul Hamid rahimahullah. He said, أحكام الفعل. Let's read Ibn Jarramiyyah what he said. قال فالماضي مفتوح الآخر أبدا والأمر مجزوم أبدا والمضارع ما كان في أول إحدى الزوائد الأربع التي يجمعها قولك أنيت وهو مرفوع أبدا حتى يدخل عليه ناصب أو جازم وأقول I will say محمد حيدين عبد الحميد سينس وأقول I will say بعد أن بين المصنف after the author explained أنواع الأفعال the types of verbs شرع he went into في بيان أحكام كل نوع منها he went into explaining شرع means what أي دخل أي خاض he indulged he went into في بيان in explaining أحكام كل نوع all the different types منها from them فحكم الفعل الماضي the what The ruling of a fi'l madi is al-bina'u ala al-fath. That it's mabni ala al-fath. Wa hadha al-fath imma zahir wa imma muqaddar. Ooh, he added something onto it now. That the madi, the bina', the way that it shows is either zahir or it is what? It's either zahir or it's what? It is muqaddar. And the muqaddar, we already touched on that before. So did we not do? We did it. The muqaddar is how many types? It is three types. The muqaddar, it is three types. The lahir is lahir. Like the word nasara, fataha, daraba, haya, batala. All of those are what? They are lahir. Like in the muqaddar is which ones? Which one? Which one? What are they? What are they? What are they? They are huruf al-illa when it's at the ending, right? When huruf al-illa is at the ending. So the first one we said it is التعذر المناسبة على دفع الكراهية صح؟ يسو دفع الكراهة صح؟ لتوالي أربع حركات صح؟ جميل So it's دفع الكراهة To remove the disliked We're going to speak about it إن شاء الله تعالى soon We're going to speak about it soon بإذن الله الكريم We're going to come to it soon فحكم الفعل الماضي The ruling of a فعل الماضي is البناء على الفتح It is to place بناء on it as a فتحة وهذا الفتح The فتحة is always on it Always But it's either what? ظاهرة مخطر That's it Either you can see that and it's explicit which is ظاهر or it is what? مقدر which is implicit مقدر means what? Implicit You can't see it. It's there but you can't see it أما الفتح he's now going to go into it ففي الصحيح الآخر الذي لم يتصل به واو الجماعة ولا ضمير رفع المتحرك وكذلك في كل ما كان آخره واو أو ياء نحو أكرم وقدم وسافر ونحو سافرت زينب وحاضر السعاد ونحو رضي وشقي ونحو سرورا سارو سارو وبذوا The Shaykh Nahawi goes into it, he says, أَمَّا الْفَتْحُ الظَّاهِرُ As for the first type of the بِنَاءُ عَلَى الْفَتْحِ showing, which is a ظاهر, the explicit one, فَفِي الصَّحِيحِ الْآخِرِ It is the letter which is what? It is صَحِيحُ الْآخِرِ In other words, at the ending of the word, there is not what? Any حُرُوفُ عِلَّةِ There's no حُرُوفُ عِلَّةِ Very good. Let me give you guys a diagram first. Does anyone have a tissue? No, tissue. Jazakallahu khairan. Pay attention here, brothers. What do we need? Al-Zahir, right? Such as? Like Nasara. Nasara. And then we have here? المقدر. التعذر. Such as رمى. We have التعذر. Like فهمت. Yeah. صح في جنبه. بسم الله. أنا المناسبة. Okay, pay attention here. When is it ظاهر? Brothers, when is it ظاهر? When none of these three happen to it. What's the first one? What happened to this? So ظاهر means when it's explicit. You can actually see. Can you see the fatha on the nasara? The bina al fatha, can you see it? Is it ظاهر? Is it apparent? Huh? It is apparent, right? Pay attention. But these are all explicit, implicit. You can't see it. The reason why you can't see it is because the ظاهر, which is the explicit one, it can be seen because none of these three can happen to it. That's what Ibn Ajurrum is telling you. What does he say? فَفِي الصَّحِيحِ الْآخِرِ فَفِي الصَّحِيحِ الْآخِرِ. So this is what? This is مُعْتَلُّ الْآخِرِ. This is مُعْتَلُّ الْآخِرِ. This is مُعْتَل from the ending. It's defected from the ending. True or false? صحيح, it is. Because he has the ending of it, إِذَا كَانَ آخِرُهُ أَلِفًا. رَمَى is أَلِف. حَرْفَ عِلَّة. So it's تَعَذُّر. You can't say it here. أَوِ الْمُنَاسَبَةِ. Look what he says. مُنَاسَبَة is what? الَّذِي لَمْ يَتَّصِلْ بِهِ وَوُ الْجَمَعَةِ. So وَوُ الْجَمَعَةِ cannot connect to it. So it hasn't got... It's صحيح الآخر. So the ظاهر is what? It's صحيح الآخر. It doesn't have وَوُ الْجَمَعَةِ. Because if وَوُ الْجَمَعَةِ goes into, what does it become? مُنَاسَبَة. Are we all together, brothers? This is what he's trying to say to you. وَلَا ضَمِيرُ رَفْعِ الْمُتَحَرِّكِ. And a ضَمِيرُ رَفْعِ الْمُتَحَرِّكِ cannot enter it. The ضَمِيرُ رَفْعِ الْمُتَحَرِّكِ is the ta. Because if a ta connects to it, what's going to happen? دَفْعُ الْكَرَاهَةِ. نُحَات, they said it's disliked for four harakat to be right under each other for a word. Okay? So if somebody asks you, what is a ظاهر? For the فعل الماضي, you say فحكم الفعل الماضي البناء وعلى الفتح وهذا إما ظاهر وإما مقدر أما الفتح الظاهر ففي الصحيح الآخر is the one who is صحيح الآخر الذي لم يتصل بواو الجماعة number two ولا ضمير رفع المتحرك and no ضمير رفع المتحرك is connected to it because if it becomes معتل الآخر what happens it's called التعذر. If it becomes اتصل بواو الجماعة, what happens? مناسبة happens. What about if a ضمير رفع المتحرك connects to it? دفع الكراهة. Does that make sense, brothers? So in other words, the ظاهر is when those three are not there. Okay? Let's go into the مقدر now. The مقدر is what? I explained it to you. So he gave you an example of it. أكرم وقدم وسافر وسافرت زينب وحضرت سعاد هي سعد Pay attention here. I want you to ponder here. We have two words here. Think about it, Guled. If he doesn't, Sa'ad doesn't answer it, Guled, you're next, okay? Safartu. Safartu. What is the issue with this one? Is it madhi, by the way? Is it madhi? Okay. Is it ظاهر or is it مقدر? It's مقدر. Why is it مقدر? Huh? No, but why is it مقدر first of all? Because the fatha can't show on it. We can't see the fatha on the what letter we're we looking at? The ra is the last letter. Okay, why? دفع الكراهة. What happened? It can't happen. Why? Yeah. Yeah. Why is it? Why is it? Why is it the case? Because the second one doesn't have it. The second one doesn't have it. سافرت. And سافرت we have. I go let. It's your moment to shine, Aki. It's your moment to shine. Yeah, they both have ta. What, so the first ta is called ضمير رفع المتحرك. Jameel, that's what we need to know. So here you say دفع الكراهة because there's ضمير رفع المتحرك, which is the ta. Are we together? The ta here, ضربت. That tu by itself is a fa'il. That's ضمير رفع المتحرك. It stands, it holds its own weight. It's an ism. That ta is an ism, by the way. All together. Hey, what about the next one? Is the second one, is it ظاهر or is it مقدر? The second one. ظاهر, we see the fatha, right? Why is it دفع القراها? What it means harf? This ta is called ta tahdith sakina. That ta tahdith. So that, what did we say to you here? That ta has no, it just shows that the person who did this action is a female. That's all it shows. It's not a fa'il. Are we all together? Pay attention. The ta that we're saying is daf'ul karaha is which one? Dhamir raf'ul mutaharrik. It's which one? Dhamir raf'ul mutaharrik. If it's dhamir raf'ul mutaharrik, then it becomes what? It becomes a muqaddar. Are we all on the same page? And there are many more ضمير رفع المتحرك. The ta is just an example. We've got ta in fa'ilayn. We also have the noon and the noon niswa. All of them are, they could all be it, right? All of them are the same. Sahih? All of them are the same. It's not just the fahim tu. It could be ta in fa'ilayn. It could also be what? It could be noon al-tawkid, no, noon niswa, sorry. And it can also be the noon of nahnu, us, and etc. Okay, is that well understood? Are we all together? You know what I mean when I say noon, fahimna, we understood. It's the same as fahimtu. Fahimna, we understood. Because that na itself is a nahnu. You can say it like that. وَفَهِبْنَا They understood, the women understood. This is also صَدَمِ الرَّفْعِ الْمُتَحَرِّكِ. Is it not? It is. We'll stop there, inshaAllah ta'ala. Anything which I have said that was wrong or incorrect is from me, shaytan, and Allah and His Messenger are free from it. سُبْحَانَكَ اللَّهُمَّ بِحَمْدِكَ أَشْهَدُ أَنْ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهُ أَسْتَغْفِرُكَ وَأَتُوبُ إِلَيْهِ.